الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. فقال جل وعلا: وإنه لعلم للساعة. وقال سبحانه وتعالى: وما قتلوه وما صلبوه ولكن شبه لهم وإن الذين اختلفوه فيه لفي شك منه ما لهم به من علم إلا اتباع الظن وما قتلوه يقينا بل رفعه الله إليه وكان الله عزيزا حكيما. وقال سبحانه وتعالى: وإن من أهل الكتاب إلا ليؤمنن به قبل موته ويوم القيامة يكون عليهم شهيدا. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: والذي نفسي بيده ليوشكن أن ينزل فيكم ابن مريم حكما عدلا فيكسر السليب ويقتل الخنزير ويضع الحرب ويفيض المال حتى لا يقبله أحد حتى تكون السجدة الواحدة خيرا من الدنيا وما فيها. رواه الإمامان البخاري والمسلم في صحيحهما. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: إن عيسى لم يمت وإنه راجع إليكم قبل يوم القيامة، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. Respected brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrates that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said: وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ لَيُوشِكَنَّ أَنْ يَنْزِلَ فِيكُمْ إِبْنُ مَرْيَمْ حَكَمًا عَدْلًا. That I swear by the one in whose hands my life is in, surely very soon the son of Maryam will descend amongst you as a just ruler. فَيَكْسِرُ الصَّلِيبِ. He will break the cross that the Christians worship. وَيَقْتُلُ الْخِنْزِيرِ. He will kill the pig the Christians consider halal to eat. وَيَضَعُ الْحَرْبِ. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will abolish the tax, the jizya. وَيَفِيضُ الْمَالِ حَتَّى لَا يَقْبَلَهُ أَحَدٌ. And during his time there will be so much wealth that nobody will be in need of wealth to the extent that the receiving of zakat and sadaqah will be discarded. حَتَّى تَكُونَ السَّجْدَةُ الْوَاحِدَةُ خَيْرًا مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. One prostration will be better than the world and everything within the world. One of the signs of the end of time is the descension of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam from the heavens where he is at this moment in time alive. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will descend once Imam Mahdi and the Dajjal appear. He will kill the Dajjal And thereafter he will live for a period of time. He will die a physical death. And he will be buried with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Next to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Though today's lesson should be dedicated only to the descendant of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, as has been advertised, as only his descension and return is a major sign of Qiyamah. However, I have decided to split today's lesson into three. I will very briefly begin with Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam's birth, as his birth was a miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a sign of the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Moving on to his ascension, how and why he was raised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the heaven, and finishing off with his descension, when he will descend, and what Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will do after he returns to the world for the second time. The reason I have chosen to do this, though the whole lesson should have been dedicated to the descension and the return of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, is because we live in Kufristan, the land of the Kuffar. You and I, we were all educated in that school. At this moment in time, our children, our brothers, our sisters, our young ones are educated in their school. And what happens in these schools? All year round, they are bombarded with stories, beliefs regarding Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, which totally contradict the Muslim belief regarding Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. Especially now in the month of November, a month before Christmas time, they are bombarded and brainwashed with beliefs which go against the Quran and the teachings and the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our children are told that Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam was crucified. Our children are told that Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam died on the cross. And our children come home with these beliefs. And our smaller ones begin to believe what their teachers taught them. This is because they have never been taught the story of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam according to the Quran and Sunnah. Our children have never been taught that Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam was not crucified. They are never taught that he is not died. They are never taught that Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam is alive at this moment in time and was raised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and will descend before the end of time as a major sign of the end of time. Either because the modern day parents have no time to teach their children, the story of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, but have the time for everything else. Or either because we ourselves do not know the story of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. We ourselves are ignorant of the story of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. This is why I have decided to split today's lesson into three. Let us begin with his birth, and let the Quran relate to you the story of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. As the Quran are the words of Allah, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا. And whose words can be better than the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Creator? The Quran says, وَالْقُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمْ إِذِ انْتَبَذَتْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا مَكَانًا شَرْقِيًّا فاتخذت من دونهم حجابا فأرسلنا إليها روحنا فتمثل لها بشرا سويا. Relate to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the story of Maryam and how she gave birth to Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, so they recognize our qudra, so they recognize the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hazrat Maryam's mother's name was Hannah and her father was Imran. Hannah and Imran were both very pious and well respected amongst their people. However, Hannah and Imran had no children of their own. And Hannah would pray day and night, and she would weep bitterly, and she would ask Allah for a child. Oh Allah, give me a child. Oh Allah, grant me a child who will be the coolness of my eyes and the content of my heart. She would ask day and night, and she would weep bitterly, and she would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a child. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers everybody's prayers, and He answers the prayer of Hannah. Her prayer was answered, and within a few days, Hannah was expecting a child. Overcome with joy and happiness that she was to expect a child, Hannah vowed, Rabbi, inni nazartu laka ma fi batni muharraran, fataqabbal minni, innaka anta as-sami'ul 'alim. She vowed that she would dedicate this child to the service of the Al-Aqsa, the Holy Mosque in Jerusalem. Her husband Imran died before she gave birth to Hazrat Maryam alayhi salam. فلما